Almost 30 years ago, the world lost one of its most talented and influential rappers.
He's dead.
In this video, I'm going to take a look
all of them
at the day he died.
You're waking up paranoid. I'd be really scared.
And what may have led to it. On March 9th, 1997, the world lost one of its most talented and influential rappers when Notorious B.I.G died in Los Angeles. While his death is still a mystery, there are many theories about what may have led to his demise.
If FBI was following my son, where were they?
Investigating alleged ties between some of Biggie's business associates and the New York Genovese Mafia family.
In this video, I'm going to take a look at the day he died and try to piece together what may have happened. Before we dive in, please make sure to like and subscribe to my channel. Your support means a lot to me and helps me to maximize the quality of my videos. Thank you and enjoy the video.
As he left a party in Los Angeles, Wallace, also known as Biggie Smalls, was shot from a passing vehicle.
By shooting Saturday night, and that story tops our world headlines. A mural is painted in New York to honor the slain rapper by a group that wants to promote peace. Rapper Tupac Shakur is also pictured in the mural. Police say they're not sure if the shooting is related in any way to Shakur's death last September.
The two rappers were rumored to be rivals, but police say they are not aware of any connection in the murders.
Vibe magazine sponsored the event, and its founder, Quincy Jones, was there. The renowned composer and producer was shocked by Wallace's passing.
We at Primetime have been reporting on the violence in the world of rap music. This week, that world took another ugly turn when one of the best-selling rap artists was killed in Los Angeles in a hail of gunfire. Tonight, that murder remains unsolved. But as chief investigative correspondent Brian Ross reports, police suspect that a long smoldering feud may be behind the latest murder.
Early this morning at Kennedy Airport, the body of Biggie Smalls was returned to New York from Los Angeles, where he had been shot and killed over the weekend in the latest round of violence.
Faith Evans, Wallace's estranged wife, as well as other partygoers, security personnel, and parking attendants, saw the shooting. But late on Sunday, authorities claimed they had no description of the shooter, and eyewitnesses were reluctant to cooperate with investigators.
Peter Thomas, a rap music promoter who was with Biggie Smalls minutes before he was killed, says it is the music itself, with its inflammatory lyrics, that has fueled the violence.
You're not just talking to an individual, you're talking to a complete community. And in that community, there's a lot of people that have absolutely no sense, you know, but they do have a 45.
Biggie Smalls' murder follows by 6 months, almost to the day, the remarkably similar killing in Las Vegas. There was a time when Tupac and Biggie Smalls were close friends, rapping together, staying at each other's apartment.
Bags on toes, watching the stash grow, clocking the cash flow.
Biggie Smalls talked about it for a program to be broadcast this week on Black Entertainment Television.
We two individual people, we waged a coastal beat. You know what I'm saying? One man against one man made a whole West Coast hate a whole East Coast and vice versa.
Suge Knight, for some reason, had a friend or a cousin or a nephew, got shot down in Atlanta, Georgia. He blamed Puffy and hell break loose.
Some believe the issues began when Suge Knight and Puff Daddy went to an Atlanta birthday celebration for musician Jermaine Dupri. Big Jake Robles, a friend of Knight and a member of Death Row, was fatally shot as he was getting into a limousine. As a result of conflict between the two factions spilled outside the club, Knight claimed that Puffy was responsible for the shooting.
The last 2 years, He had been arrested in both New York and New Jersey on weapons and assault charges, including one alleged attack on two autograph seekers with a baseball bat.
We don't kill them, we murder them. It's a difference, you know what I'm saying? Chill is blah, 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 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Murderers wake up dead.
Talking about his music in a recent interview, Biggie said he was trying to get away from his tough guy image with a new album due later this month called Life After Death.
Big Papa ain't going nowhere, you know what I'm saying? And if you thought the first album was a fluke, hold your head. Because this winter, man, it's all on, dog. It's all like you never thought. The next album is called Life After Death, and we ain't taking no prisoners.
In the last days of his life, Biggie Smalls had gone to Los Angeles, Tupac's home turf, creating such a commotion that he and his entourage were kicked out of the Four Seasons Hotel.
My son was just a little upcoming rapper in California for an award.
On Friday night, he was a presenter at the Soul Train Music Awards.
What's up, Cali?
Cheered and jeered by a West Coast audience. Throughout the weekend, Primetime has learned, Biggie Smalls' every move in Los Angeles was being tracked by an undercover team of agents from a federal task force here in New York, investigating alleged ties between some of Biggie's business associates and the New York Genovese Mafia family.
If FBI was following my son, where were they that night my son was shot?
I think somebody's trying to kill me. I'll be waking up paranoid. I'll be really scared. I'll just be paranoid. That's just the way I am. You know? If you stream, scared to death.
Who would want to stop this promising young artist from reaching his potential? We will provide the answers in this program.
We did it, Brooklyn, we did it! All of you did it! But nothing. All of them. What about the organ?
The Notorious B.I.G.'s body lay at the Frankie Campbell Funeral Home in Upper East Side of Manhattan. A star-studded event ensued with the likes of Lil' Kim, Jay-Z, Puff Daddy, Maze, and Junior Mafia members arriving to pay their final respects. While for some, the atmosphere was emotionally harrowing, few could be more challenged than Lil Cease, as he sat right behind Biggie, barely looking away long enough not to see who it was that brought an end to his friend's life. With reality permeating and almost cutting into the air like a broken record, one can't help but think of how unsettling all this became. The news of the hearse carrying Big's coffin filled Fort Greene with a heavy gloom as it wound through his former neighborhood. Fans lined the streets, gathering to offer their final farewells to the beloved rapper. Despite the strong air of grief, passionate chants filled the cold air as tributes were offered up for the renowned figure. During these confusing and grievous times, mourning supporters released bundles of roses along with plaintive cries in hope that these would transcend the barriers between life and death itself. Biggie Smalls was sent off with one final heartfelt goodbye, eventually allowing his soul to rest in peace.
Investigators tell ABC News that unlike the murder of Tupac Shakur, there are eyewitnesses who are willing to talk, and police are preparing a composite sketch of a possible suspect.
That guy.
I got right there.
That's him.
Yeah.
We ever shown his picture before. That's definitely him, though.
Yep.
This is another example of how incomplete the investigation is. These types of statements made by witnesses need to be thoroughly followed up on.
Russell Poole's theory is that off-duty LAPD officers were involved in the shooting of Biggie, and Suge Knight used members from his personal security team, who were LAPD officers moonlighting for Death Row Records, to assist in the hit of the rapper.
Law enforcement officers were working for Death Row, and that was a scandal in itself, okay? The fact that law enforcement officers were working for gangsters, known felons, basically organized crime.
Poole has Amir Muhammad as the for hire trigger man. Amir Muhammad denies having any knowledge or involvement, including a $400 million lawsuit against the LAPD, asserting that officers David Matt and Rafael Perez were responsible for the shooting. In a cover-up, Katie was given the case in 2006. Later, that lawsuit was dropped.
I was assigned to Biggie's case as a result of a reinvestigative effort by the LAPD.
Kading's theory: Suge Knight used his gang ties and hired Wardell Poochie Faust while Knight was incarcerated for 1995 parole violation that stemmed from the MGM altercation. He thinks Poochie dressed up like a member of the Nation of Islam to cause confusion. In 2006, Cuba Gooding Jr. plays alongside Clifton Collins Jr. in a film called Dirty. It's loosely based on David Mack and Rafael Perez's Days of Corruption. Remember to like, subscribe, comment if you want more content.